Hi everyone, this is the third video in the Stack and Queue video series, and in this video I'm going to talk about how to implement a queue using a linked list. Now, we talked a little bit about how to do implement a stack using a linked list in the previous video, and the same rules pretty much apply to a queue. If you are using a doubly linked list, you can implement the enqueue function using either push front or push back. But once you have made the choice on how to implement push, you have also chosen how to implement the DQ function. So where you put something in determines where you take something out, because a queue is first in, first out. So where is the oldest item in the queue? That's the one you have to remove. So if you wrote push front, you have to also write pop back, okay? Because you're putting it at the front, you're taking it out from the back. Similarly, if you take it out from the back, if you put it in at the back, you take it out from the front. It's always opposite with a queue, okay? So let's talk about the implementation. So again, make sure that you take your lab 4 and 3 code, put them together so that you have all of the push and pop functions and all the iterator functionality from labs 3 and 4. And that is effectively forms the basis of what you will need for your linked list. From there, choose one of your linked lists for implementation. And it doesn't matter which one it is. The only difference is in this one line where we do the declaration. So here is the queue object. Again, the constructor doesn't need anything because it is basically done with this one declaration. We're finished with it. It's just a standard queue declaration. When we do an enqueue, what do we do? Well, what we do is we start off by saying, taking the queue and then putting the data in somewhere. Now, for me, just like if we think about how we wrote the stack, which is over here, I don't like this particular statement. I think this is very awkward. I prefer this. So in other words, I want to be able to take something out from the front. Now, if that is the goal, if I want to be able to take something out from the front, then I have to be putting things in at the back. So for me, the better choice for how I implement the queue object is to do a push back, because that will allow me to pop front. Okay, so remember that with a queue, it's the oldest item that gets removed. The oldest item is opposite to where you push. If you push in the back, the oldest item is at the front. If you push in the front, the oldest item is in the back. So make sure you know which one is which. So I'm gonna do a push back, and there we go. So if I push back, then over here in the DQ function, what do? I do this and I say DQ dot pop front. Okay, so it's simply opposite. And just like before, if I chose the Q dot push front, I could do that too. But then if I did that, then over here I would have to write the queue dot pop back. It has to be opposite in the push and pop functions. Otherwise you have a stack. So that's pretty much what it comes down to. These have to be opposite to each other. This is push back, this is pop front, or this is push front, and then this is pop back. With the front function, where are you removing from? That's the end that you will want to, that's the end where you will be getting the data from, right? The thing that we care about. So this code is exactly the same as the code for the stack. So I'm going to borrow that and simply paste it in. So if I push front, if I push back, the oldest item is at the front. So I simply return cbegin. Otherwise, I return the thing that is before cend. For empty, it is simply returning whether the, oops, I have to The Q dot C begin is equivalent to the Q dot C end, and that's pretty much it. Sorry, I need to change this to Q. Just notice that. Okay. And that is pretty much how you would implement a queue using a linked list. It's pretty much the same as the way you would think about a stack. Just make sure that these are opposites. That's pretty much the only real difference here. And then matching up the functions accordingly. Okay. The same that we talked about for a doubly linked list, again, you can have two options. For a singly linked list, just like with the stack, we have to avoid popback. Popback is the slow function for a singly linked list. So if we were to implement this using a singly linked list as opposed to a doubly linked list, this the version that is not commented is the only valid version, because otherwise you would have a slow dequeue. Okay, we have to avoid this function if it's singly linked. That's pretty much it for a queue implementation using a linked list. Thank you. Next up, we're going to talk about how to implement a stack using an array as opposed to a linked list.